morning. Just wanted to show a couple things I did this last week. I actually have two motors up there now, and I don't know if it's right, but it works. And I got my shifter for the shaper now. Runs all right. I haven't had that running in a while. And run this. I can have all three running. That's all I got set up for the moment. And I had this little problem up here. If you look at that shaft is bent or warped. So what I did yesterday was I had the bearing hanger right there, and I put another support, moved it down to the end of the shaft to see if it would run better, but you can see that shaft is it's bent. So I think my only recourse, I wanted to use this shaft. It's very old. I bought it from a gentleman over in Sebastopol. He must have had it sitting out there in his backyard for probably 50 years. He was 94 when I bought it from him. Todd, a great guy. And this shaft, I believe, is a wrought iron. It's delaminating in a couple of places. You can see the, the silicone slag inclusions in it. So I'm pretty sure this is a wrought iron shaft, and I really wanted to use it in here because I like everything to be old. I put a coupler so the shaft wasn't long enough for the whole trailer, and I bought this little section right here is a new inch and 7/16 coal roll, and I guess as long as I don't use that end of the shaft, I can leave it there. But looks like I might have to replace it with some modern coal roll. This shaft over here I got from Todd also. This is an old 1 11/16. These cast iron pulleys, a little bit froze on there. That's why they're up there. They don't really do anything, but I wasn't able to get them off. And I still wanted to use the shaft because it's old. Actually, the little power jack shaft I put up here, I don't know how old that is, because I bought that up here at a gas engine flea market out of Woodland, and it was all a complete unit. This one over here, I found the hangers and course, the wooden pulley and everything. But that's a new shaft too. That's an inch and an eighth. I got a couple more sets of hangers that are inch and an eighth. Well, I think I'm gonna hang them from right here over the workbench. I got a little grinder, a little flat belt grinder that runs the right direction. So I think I'm gonna put it right here. And I was able to get my little drill press back here. So now it's hanging back on the corner. And I put it so that when we're driving, when I'm towing it, that it's a little just miss down the side of the trailer so we could tow, and then once we get where we're going and we bring it out here, I'll put some stops bolted down. But we're getting there. I'm gonna make it. I still got 5 months, and apparently I work better if I got a deadline. And it was probably the best thing that I got this deadline, so that I can get things done, move forward. Quit doing the gingerbread. Let me show you a little bit of kind of how I waste my time. I hope you can see that. But these little machinery nameplates, I kind of like those. This one here, W.O. Hickok. I don't know if that stands for William Hickok, Bob Bill Hickok, out of Harrisburg, Pennsylvania. Early one. But I gotta quit spending time doing this stuff that really doesn't help anything run. Well, got any comments, leave them down below, and thank you for watching. Bye.